Antimicrobials are among the most commonly prescribed drugs in any period of life, and in children they are very commonly used even for the treatment of viral infections. So this means that in that cases there is an abuse on antibiotic prescriptions, and in other cases of bacterial infections there is a misuse, that means that a wrong antibiotic is prescribed. So this means that rules to contain the antimicrobial prescriptions are extremely important in the first years of life. And one of these methods is represented by antimicrobial stewardship, so a sort of recommendation that should be checked carefully and that has the aim to reduce the large use of antibiotics and also the use of large spectrum antibiotics. So the first point is to reduce the use, and the second point is to reduce the use of large spectrum antibiotics. Why this? Because this abuse and misuse of antibiotics has an impact in terms of antimicrobial resistance, and it is extremely important to limit the antimicrobial resistance of pathogens that usually are commonly present in the skin, I mean, or in the airways of the persons, and that if exposed to this kind of drugs can be associated then with the selection of resistance. So the experience on antimicrobial stewardship is quite large in the adult population, but also in children there are programs that have been implemented, and at the end these programs that could be conducted at the hospital level but also the community level has reached important goal in terms of reduction of antibiotic abuse and in terms of reduction of antibiotic misuse. Anyway, only the studies of the next year could clarify if these strategies can permit to reduce the increase that we have nowadays in the risk of antimicrobial resistance. It is clear that there are some settings, like for example the neonatal intensive care unit and the pediatric intensive care unit, in which the antimicrobial stewardship programs have been already evaluated with success. And this means that the cooperation should include different figures, the medical doctors, but also the nurses, also the pharmacy team of the hospital, and the microbiology team, just to check the prescriptions and at the circulating pathogens. Anyway, also at the community level, or even in the normal pediatric ward, it will be extremely important to evaluate the impact of programs that can have a significant value for the public health.